Hi students, coming to the next topic, that is the multiple access techniques. So there are different types of multiple access techniques in the view of the wireless communication. The first one is the frequency division multiple access, time division multiple access, we call it as TDMA, code division multiple access, and the space division multiple access. So let us discuss one by one. The first multiple access is a frequency division multiple access. So here, if you see the word, the abbreviation here, FDMA, frequency division, a multiple access. Actually, what is a multiple access? The multiple access are nothing but, let's take here, this is a base station, okay, it's a So here these are the different nodes, the mobile devices. A single station is communicating with the so many devices. Okay, so here this is a multiple access. So one access point is communicating with the sending the information to so many devices at a time. That is a multiple access. A multiple access technology. So here it is sending, here sending and sending, or receiving, sending, sending and the receiving, everything will be communicating. So that's this concept, you call it as a multiple access. Then what about this, the frequency division multiple access? The FDMA assigns individual channels to individual users. So the main concept of the frequency division multiple access is, here the access point is there, okay, the access point, which is a base station. So this base station is providing signals to all the devices which are in that range. Here the FDMA works as, it is assigning individual channels to individual users. So this is one user, another user, and user. So different users are there in this range. So this base station is providing an individual channels to individual users. So each channel is assigned to one user. So that should be within the bandwidth. So the thing, main thing you have to remember that it should divide the channels to all the users within the bandwidth. So here each user is allocated a unique frequency or a band or a channel. So that means whatever the user that we are taken, each user is assigned with a unique frequency or a unique band or a unique channel. These channels are assigned on a demand to users who request service. So it's the channels will be allocated to the users on demand basis, on demand to the users who request the services. So the first who requests the service, okay, so the signals can be distributed, the channels can be distributed to each and every user until the bandwidth, okay. So if the bandwidth is extended, means suppose a limited bandwidth is there, all the channels, all the users are communicating, every bandwidth is completely full, okay. Suppose if another user came, there is no channel to assign for that. So in that case, the channel has to be that user has to be wait until it gets the signal, or it may be destroyed, okay. So that is, these channels, whatever the channels that are there, are assigned on demand to users who request service. During the period of the call, okay, during the period of the call, no other user can share the same channel. So this is the important topic, concept. During, suppose you are talking, you are on the call, your channel is not supposed to take another one. Means here the frequency division multiple access technique is there. Because of that technique, each channel will be assigned to the particular user. So those channel will not be shared by the other. Okay, if it is shared, suppose maybe some problem occur, if it shared, multiple calls will be communicated. So did you observe, when you are calling to someone, suppose you and your friend are talking, in between another call will be come, means some other person is voice is hearing you, not only your friend's voice, you will sometimes listen some other voice due to some problem in the network. What is the problem? Because the channel will be shared by the other person also in some cases. Okay, there if there is a problem, that is if there is a frequency division multiple access, if the problem is rises, that channel will be shared to the other person. So this FDMA technique is take care during the period of call, no other user can share the same channel. The frequency division multiple access channel carries only one phone circuit at a time. So that is so far what I said. So in frequency division multiple access, if an FDMA channel is not in use, suppose if you take, if the channel is not in use, you're in the station within the limit and this is the base station for your devices. Okay. Suppose if the FDMA channel is not in the use, then it sits ideal and cannot be used by other users. So if that channel is not in use means it is not in use and it cannot be used by the other users. So this channel will be assigned to this mobile device, and if suppose the communication is not here, there is no communication is establishing, it has to be wait, sit ideal until he disconnects the call and cannot be used by other users. FDMA requires tight radio frequency filterings to minimize adjacent channel interface. Okay, the FDMA requires tight RF filtering to minimize adjacent channel interface. Means this is a channel 1 and channel 2. So here we have to be maintained, there is an interface will be there. This channel is interfacing to this channel. There is a chance to avoid that interfacing. It requires a tight RF filtering to minimizing the adjacent channel interface. So this you call it as a guard, safeguard. So for each channel, a safeguard will be provided. So it avoids the interfacing, means minimizing the adjacent channel interfaces. So here this is the time and the frequency. So the frequency will be divided in the bandwidth, within the bandwidth. So this is a frequency 1 assigns to the channel 1, frequency 2 assigned to channel 3, frequency 3 is assigned to channel 3, like that. So up to n channels. So that should be in total bandwidth. Now let's see the advantages and disadvantages of FDMA. So the advantages of FDMA is, if channel is not in use, it has to sit ideal. This is the advantage. Why I am saying it is an advantage means because each channel will be assigned to a particular user. Okay. So until that user is disconnected, that channel will be allocated to that person only. So if it is not in use means it will be sit ideal. Channel bandwidth is relatively narrow. It's simple algorithmically, and from a hardware standpoint of view, it is simple or algorithmically. And the FDMA is fairly efficient. Why we call it as a fairly efficient? When the number of stations is small and the traffic is uniformly constant, and FDMA, no need of network timing is required. No restrictions regarding the type of baseband or type of modulation. So in the type of modulations, there is no restrictions. So these are the advantages of FDMA. Now let's see the disadvantages. The presence of guard bands. So here guard bands will be provided. Actually, the guard bands, whatever we are provided in between the channels, which are minimizing the adjacent channel interface. So this is an advantage only. But why I am calling it is at disadvantages. The presence of guard bands is disadvantage because those guard band space will not involve in the communication. This space will not be used by the communications or whatever the operations. So it's just simply a workstation. It requires the right RF filtering to minimize the adjacent channel interface. So adjacent channel, if you want to minimize the adjacent channel interface, it requires a RF filtering techniques will be required. And the maximum bitrate per channel is fixed. So each channel, the maximum bitrate is fixed. Beyond that, the channel will not take any more bandwidth. Small inhibiting flexibility is in bitrate capability and does not differ significantly from analog system. So these are the disadvantages and the advantages of the FDMA. Thank you.